Lisa, when it's taking more than a week, as you mentioned, to get those test results back, well, that is precious time during which a person who has the virus could unknowingly be infecting others. And now a Folsom biotech company called StemExpress is using its capabilities to help Sacramento County get more testing done faster. And earlier today, I had a chance to speak with the CEO, Cate Dyer. She told me the benchmark for churning out those test results is 72 hours or less. So, Cate, what is it that StemExpress is going to be able to do to help with this quick turnaround that other companies or the county couldn't get done on its own?
I think number one is, you know, we have the volume. So, I mean, we've brought on just here in Folsom, you know, we have the ability to do 10,000 tests a day every 24 hours. And so, I mean, that's a tremendous amount of bandwidth in comparison to, you know, other facilities in the region that may, you know, be able to do 1,000 tests in 24 hours. I think, you know, scalability and rapid turnaround is really the key of what we're offering here in this sort of crisis in this time. You know, we want to be helpful beyond just, you know, what people can do and send their tests to LabCorp and Quest. You know, I know those timeframes can vary, but, you know, I think we're back to around 8 to 15 days are most of those turnaround times. And, you know, it's just, your test becomes irrelevant at a certain point. If you were tested, you know, potentially a day of exposure in the same day and your result comes back 15 days later telling you you're negative, when in fact you've become positive during that time, you know, it really brings to question how valid is that test.
Are there certain people that you want to get tested right now? Are we looking for people who only have symptoms, people who are just generally curious, people who are, you know, think they may be asymptomatic? Who are we looking for here? Because I think one of the challenges for a lot of these businesses, especially, is getting our positivity rate down, which means testing people who don't have it.
Yeah, and Brian, I have to tell you, that's what you just asked is probably the most crucial question, I think, to be discussed today in this time point. So we are seeing a tremendous amount of people that have zero symptoms whatsoever testing positive. So, you know, I think it's really concerning to people because they've just known that if you have these symptoms that you may have it. But actually a large version of the people that are carrying this virus don't actually have much symptoms at all. They may think they're having allergies. They may think they just feel a little bit tired because of the weather, and they don't actually understand that they're a carrier. And so what we've seen in testing, for example, an entire restaurant or an entire location, is that they think they may have one person on staff that's positive, when in fact it could be 10% of their staff. And so it's really crucial to be able to do that rapidly, be able to pull people off the line in whatever sort of position or workforce that they're in, and be able to segregate those people that are healthy.
And this partnership with StemExpress has allowed Sacramento County to resume the free testing at 5 community-based testing sites. You do need to make an appointment, and you can find a list of those county testing sites right now on the Sacramento County Health Department's website. Dalston?
All right, good information there for us, Brian. Thank you so much.